Is Carter bringing his plays?
A lot of talent. You saw in that last play just made on Dontrell. He's very athletic, plays the ball well, very instinctive. So he's played against these guys in the past. So that's a bonus.
You also saw Noel kicking field goals. Can we take anything from that?
No. Swayze's at the doctor. I'm not even sure exactly what Swayze's doing right now at the doctor. Swayze's fine.
He got a note from the coach, though.
What? Yeah, he got a note. He got
I thought
a
maybe
pass.
He went back to Arendelle to hunt for Bambi.
No. No, he's fine.
Scott, Mark Trestman warned his players about not saying too much this week. You give your players a similar edict?
Yes, I did. Twice now. So, we're trying to stay humble and just play the game.
Where are you in preparation right now? Are you happy with the way that this week has gone and with what you as a staff have given them to work with?
Yeah, so far it's been good. Today, this afternoon, we do offensive release, we do red zone, and then basically the game plan's in. So it's gone well so far. They seem to be doing well with it.
How good were you on film against Edmonton now that you broke down the offense?
After the first quarter, we were pretty good. I mean, we got into a lead where we didn't have to be great in the second half. But we did what we wanted to do. We were able to move the sticks and run the football and start killing the clock. Ricky played very, very well after the first quarter and protected the ball. So it was a solid effort.
There have been some slow starts this year of late. Any theory as to why?
No, I don't have a theory. We've also had some fast starts. And I just think sometimes that's the way it works out. And, Hopefully, we'll start fast on Sunday. It'll help us.
Noah, how are you guys progressing with the North?
I think it's coming fine. I mean, the positive was that we're not too far away from when we played at Regina, which was a silent game for us. So the guys seem to be doing well with it. It's nice to be in here and be able to simulate the environment a little bit. I think it'll be louder than this, but I think the guys have done a good job so far.
Not a history. I mean, there's not a great history of Argo success in Montreal in this particular game. What kinds of things can you tell your guys to maybe reverse that trend? I think it's 1-5 since 2002.
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of guys that weren't here then, and we don't really concern ourselves with what happened in the past. This was a new season, new expectations, new goals for us, and we're playing our best football right now. And they're a great team, and they're home, and they've got a lot going for them too, but I expect our guys to go in there and compete.
On the other side, was that environment a big boost for the home team just because it is so very, very loud?
Yeah, it's absolutely an advantage when, especially if they can get it rolling and start getting hot, then the crowd seems to pick up. If the other team's able to come in and get off to a lead, it's not as much of a factor. So it'd be great to play with the lead. It doesn't always happen that way, but we're going to have to be prepared to play 60 minutes to win this game.
How much difference can a coach make in this type of game?
I don't know the menu. I don't get to throw it or tackle anybody.
To devise a game plan.
Yeah, we do. And we're going to give them, like every week, we'll give them the best one we can. And, ultimately about 70 or 80% of those plays work out the way you want them to. And then guys have to execute on their own a little bit, too. Like Ricky pulling that one down last week and running for the first down. So. We'll do the best we can for them, but they have to play, and we're all accountable for the final score.
How are you looking? Do you expect the high school, given the nature of these two D offenses?
I don't ever expect anything. I mean, I don't expect it to be low. I don't try to play the game that way. I mean, I always hope that we'll score a lot on offense and not give up very many, but I think every game's different. I don't think you can look at the quarterbacks and say it's going to be a high-scoring game. Defenses prevail a lot of times in the playoffs. Over the course of the last couple of years, I think it's gone both ways. I mean, there's been some high-scoring games and some low-scoring games. So what I'm trying to do is get our guys prepared to play a full 60 minutes and understand it's going to take that. Whether you're up early or down early, it's going to take 60 minutes to finally get this one in the end.
Does it help going into this one knowing that you've won some character games on the road this year, like, Labor Day in Hamilton, Saskatchewan at the end of the year, Winnipeg without Ricky?
Yeah, I mean, I don't think our team's scared to play on the road. I think they feel comfortable, and they should. They've done a fairly good job on the road. This will be a big stage and a big environment for us, but I think our guys will respond to that.